Please continue supporting us. Like, share to all your friends. Make any comments, bad or good, it'll make us better and stronger. And subscribe to us. Here on YouTube is where you find us, where we can change the world one bite at a time.
Want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody want to bake it because it take too much time. Well, I grind. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody want to bake it because it take too much time. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody want to bake it because it take too much time. Well, I grind. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody want to bake it because it take too much time. Word must have gathered around town that I'm the man now. Now, leeches, I don't even know they got their freaking hands out. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody want to bake it because it take too much time. Well, I grind. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody want to bake it because it take too much time. Word must have gathered around town that I'm the man now. Now, leeches, I don't even know they got their freaking hands out. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody want to bake it because it take too much time. Well, I grind. See, everybody.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. Allow me to reintroduce myself.
But starting off with school is a great platform for people who have the tools. And I was using that platform to sharpen my tools. Learning, gaining experience that I didn't have before. Being in the kitchen with Granny was a true blessing from God. That's what thrusted me to be where I'm at today. You know, once I got a little older, you know, my teenage life, I wanted to raise the standard on the stuff that I cook. I wanted to leave a traditional, you know, legacy of my dishes to my kids and to the next future. You know, for they can be able to pass it on. The different creation styles of ingredients that I was mixing together, like I was a scientist in a laboratory, you know, I was trying to make something different that I can get out of that box that I grew up in when I was younger, and wanted to present a whole new dish out of the box for my family and my friends. So I became more creative in the kitchen and coming with perfect, great ideas. There's something that keeps me comfortable, my mind is at ease. For a while I was going through, I guess you could say, depression. I said to myself, you know, I get in the kitchen, I get cooking up something, and I was at peace with myself. And I believe that, you know, I have to go back to what I know, and this is what I know. I remember watching Kevin Hart in the movie Thinking Like a Man, and he had said that hit me very hard.
Fool's your art.
Stick with what you know. And right then and there was like the last light bulb to hit my head and say, okay, that's a message right there that, you know, God hid me in this movie for you. You know, it's time for you to get up and go after what you know best. And part of me having a cooking show, being on Facebook, showing all my food and stuff, really, y'all, I truly believe that we all have some type of legacy that's in us that needs to come out for people to share and see. And for me, I believe that, you know, I've been sitting here trying to budge up the art of cooking in my life, and I believe that one day it will definitely happen. Major thing in my life is I want to own my own restaurant and be able to come with my own dishes, my own style of food techniques, and to be able to give it to the world so they can taste. You know, I'm the one who firmly believes in opinions. I believe in, you know, respecting people's thoughts, what they have. But at the same time, I would want them to, you know, do the same for me, because this is all I have. This is all I got. And to be honest with you, there's nothing else in the world I would rather do but to sit back and cook something and create a dish that never been seen before. I'm here to show the world who I am and what I'm all about. And that's it. Right now, this is the biggest moment of my life. I have people that never seen me cook before, didn't know that I even knew how to cook. And now they're seeing my plates, they're seeing everything, and they're watching me. We had everything all ready for 2015. We were going to season two. We had the world premiere that day. Everything crashed, okay? And I was so teary-eyed, I was so frozen up. I was just like, oh my God, I just have so many people attention now than I ever had before. And here it is, right now today, it freezes up on me. You know, and it's like, oh my God, man, what am I gonna do? So I did all kind of things by going to use other people in this, by, you know, going other places and stuff. And it did not work out. At that moment, all I could do is leave it in God's hands. And I know that, you know, He had a plan for me. He had a plan for all this, you know. So I stepped back for a moment, and I gone ahead and I started thinking a little harder, you know, what should I do? What should I do next, you know? And, you know, God came to me, and it was like, finish doing episodes, keep on doing episodes, keep on doing them, don't stop. You know, everything that you cook that's great, tape it, put it on the side, edit it, and have it ready so when it's time to show the world, you'll have way more to show than what you had the last time. I started getting ready for school, and everything was going very well, everything was going smooth. Couple things that wasn't coming together in my elements, but you know, I knew right then and there that God had me and He had my family, and He knew that everything was going to come together beautifully. We need to change the world one bite at a time. That is something that I had thought of a long time ago. For this cooking show, it was never about trying to see some great chef or anything like that. We was reaching out to the parents that really was coming home late, trying to take care of the kids, trying to take care of themselves, trying to cook, put food on the table before it's time for, you know, nighttime. And we basically wanted to show them how to come with great dishes, great food on their table without having to sit there and say, man, we need to stop at a restaurant, get something quick to eat and everything. And you actually can do something real fast and look so delicious at home at a short period of time. Really, be honest with you, almost all 95% of the dishes that we cook on the cooking show is dinner, is breakfast, is lunch, is mostly dinner time. And you see what we eat. So if you see something that was recorded back in, let's say, December 12th, 2014, that was our food that we were rushing home to make real quick, record it at the same time, and put it on. In our home, we're both a great cookers. You know, I never want to sit back and just step on my wife's toes or anything. I'll let you know right now, she is a great cooker. She knows how to cook very well, from old traditional food, and she also likes to come with her own creation. I believe for our kids, you know, it's a blessing to have both parents knowing how to cook, because they get to learn how to cook at a young age, just like I did when I was in the kitchen with my granny. Now they're in the kitchen with their mom and their dad that's doing great dishes that, you know, they can pass on to their next generation, you know.
Everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody want to bake it because it takes too much time.
You know, it's very awesome to see that the kids are involved with all this. They're coming out with their episodes on the cooking show also. And it's going to be real great and stuff to see them do what they do and analyze what me and my wife does and everything. To see young kids involved with something like this is beautiful. I believe that we can reach out to kids and show them how to cook and give them great ideas in the kitchen. The future for the cooking show is going to be very great, man, because like I said, I'm in school and everything. I'm about to come with some new dishes that I never had done before, and I'll be mixing them up with some of my old dishes that I did. So you're going to see an upgrade of what I do and stuff, and you're going to watch me grow as this, you know, episodes keep going on and this cooking show keeps lasting. You will see the kids get more involved. You'll see wifey, you know, doing her thing more and everything. We are a family cooking show. There's nothing negative up in here. All that negative stuff is out the door, okay? We don't do none of that right here in this kitchen. So, you know, we try to keep it where it's family-like, okay? And we want to make sure that we don't disrespect nobody, but at the same time, we respect everybody, and hopefully everybody respects us and what we do. Open up people's minds with this cooking show, bringing them great dishes that you would normally wouldn't see in your culture, and bring other cultures in, bringing cultures together that most dishes. Everyone who's supporting us, who's liking our Facebook page, who's checking us out day by day, week by week. We just want to say thank you very much. God bless you for giving us the opportunity of your time. We do this here for fun. There's nothing serious about this here, but to keep it family-wise, that's the only serious thing about it. And just want to say, you know, thank you. You know, if it wasn't for you, you know, we wouldn't be where we at today. And I'm in love with cooking. I just want you to know that once again. And I just want to be able to share to the world some of the things that I have, because I never had an opportunity to show anyone my side of my cooking. You're gonna see a level of intensity that no one never seen before. The man that was told he can't, you can't do it, I can, and I will. believe that. We can change the world, one bite at a time.
But don't nobody wanna bake it, cause it take too much time. Well, I grind. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody wanna bake it, cause it take too much time. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody wanna bake it, cause it take too much time. Well, I grind. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody wanna bake it, cause it take too much time. Word must have gathered around town that I'm the man now. Now, leeches, I don't even know they got their freaking hands out. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody wanna bake it, cause it take too much time. Well, I grind. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody wanna bake it, cause it take too much time. Word must have gathered around town that I'm the man now. Now, leeches, I don't even know they got their freaking hands out. See, everybody want a piece of the pie, but don't nobody wanna.